with that person, thinking that you are trying to make him know what God has done in your life, you'll be surprised that your mouth has put you into trouble. And so when that prophecy does not come to pass, you start playing the man of God. Somebody, the man of God was just trying to cajole me. He was just trying to make me feel good. No! Your tongue could be a disaster to you getting to your what? To your land of promise. May that not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So open doors and opportunities are waiting us that we need to tap into. There are opportunities waiting for us to be tapped into before the time is too late. Brethren, open doors have a limitation. It will be there open for life. The question is, what are you doing to tap into it? I want us to consider some of the doors that are written in the Word of God. What are the doors that could be around us? There are some doors you don't want it to be opened. There are some doors you want them to be permanently opened. So which door are we talking about? The first door I will look at is the door of the temple. The door of the temple. In Nehemiah chapter 6 verse 10 and the second in Kings 18. Nehemiah was the time when Nehemiah was building the temple. He said, let us, guard this temple. Let us put ourselves inside. Let us close the door of the temple so that when those attackers come, they will not be able to catch us. So the door of the temple is one of the doors that we have. The same thing was King Hezekiah. Hezekiah what? He beautified the house of God, the temple of God. So he missed it on the long run when he went to show the temple of God to the foreign people. But the question is that the door to the temple is a specific door. Such doors should be opened. Do you agree with me? Such doors should be opened. And that's why sometimes you come to the house of God, even you can come here and you pray, you say you pour your heart unto God. That was what happened to the life of Hannah. Hannah could go to the house of God anytime because the door of the temple was open. He could come in and he could pray. You can imagine if she comes out there and Eli has locked the door. How would she be able to communicate with God? She came all the way from where she was staying to the place where she would be able to meet with God. So the door of the temple is a door. Number two is the door of the world.